The legacy still continues.
Before dawn, Malcolm Little was born in Omaha in 1925. He was one of six children born to Earl and Louise Little. Malcolm's father was a Baptist preacher and his mother was a writer for Marcus Garvey's newspaper, but due
to their defiant stance against racism and their staunch activism within the black community, the family was compelled to abandon their home and to relocate to Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 1926, but shortly thereafter, circumstances compelled them to relocate once more. This time they settled in Lansing, Michigan.
However, as in their previous homes, the family suffered frequent harassment and intimidation at the hands of local white supremacists. Soon after they moved to Lansing, their new home was burned to the ground. Tragically, the family was never compensated for their loss.
This traumatic incident would, in the tender heart of Malcolm Little, entrench a bitter sentiment of vengefulness and abhorrence for the white power structure. Unfortunate as it was, this tragedy was not to be
the last for Malcolm and his family.
The awakening storm. On a fateful September night in 1931, when Malcolm was only 6 years old, his father was brutally murdered
and dismembered by some local members of the Ku Klux Klan. His mutilated remains were found on a
railway track the next morning. The homicide was dismissed by the authorities and officially ruled to be a mere accident. Some even implied that Malcolm's father had in fact committed suicide, but Malcolm, now a six-year-old orphan, would grow up
with the conviction that his father was murdered by a group of white supremacists. The incident was not a novelty to Malcolm or to his siblings, as three of their uncles had already been killed by racist thugs. In 1938, 7 years following the murder of his father, Malcolm's mother suffered a nervous breakdown
and was sent to a mental unit in Kalamazoo State Hospital. She remained there for almost a quarter of a
century, secluded from her home and family. Sadly, resulting from this painful course of events, Malcolm and
his siblings were split up and sent to live in different foster homes.
Sunrise in Boston.
The young Malcolm excelled at West Junior High, where he was the only black student in attendance, in fact.
During the seventh grade, he was elected class president. However, he left school and abandoned his studies in the eighth grade when his English teacher had informed him that black boys could not become lawyers. Such were
the accepted norms of society.
Understandably, Malcolm felt that the white world afforded no place for an intelligent and industrious black man, regardless of his ambitions and aptitude. Having dropped out of school at the age of 14, he sought new
opportunities in Boston, where he settled with his half-sister, Ella. She resided in the middle-class locality of
Roxbury.
We know less about history than anything else. We have among our people those who are experts in every field. You and I can come out of Harvard, but we don't know our history. And the basic difference in why we are treated as we are, one knows his history and one doesn't know his history. He's a servant in America who doesn't know his history. He's a graduate from Harvard or Columbia or Yale or Howard or Tuskegee who doesn't know his history. And because he doesn't know his history, he's confined. He's limited. And all of this stems from his lack of knowledge concerning history. But when you and I wake up and learn our history, learn the history of our kind, and we're at an advantage. The only thing that puts you and me at a disadvantage is our lack of knowledge concerning history.